Welcome to another 5-pound dinner challenge where we try to feed the whole family for just under 5 pounds. Today, we're making carrot and butternut squash soup, a wonderful comfort food that feeds a family of six. Let's do it. First, we prepare our aromatic vegetables, the onion and the garlic. We mince it relatively fine just to help them cook quicker, but it doesn't really matter too much because we're going to liquidize the soup at the end. We're putting the garlic separately because it burns much faster than the onions and the carrots, especially if you crush them, because now the cell walls have been broken down. Perfect. And whatever you don't use, you can use to make garlic bread. Now, the carrots. You don't have to peel them, but you definitely need to wash them. First, we mince a couple of them, roughly the same quantity as the minced onion. This will provide some extra sweetness to the dish. Perfect. Now, for the rest, we cut them into small medallions. Now, the reason why I have two trays in front of me is because we want to build more flavors. And in order to do that, we're going to roast half of the carrots in the oven to evaporate the water content, to concentrate the flavors, to brown the sugar content a little bit so that it develops more sweetness. We'll cook the other batch in the pot, and this would maintain the carroty goodness, the carrot taste of the soup. So how you want to divide this is a personal choice. If you feel like a sweeter and a deeper soup, roast more of it. If you want the soup to taste more like blanched carrots, then cook more of it in the pot. And we'll do exactly the same with the butternut squash. You remove the seeds. We season this one with salt. And we drizzle some olive oil. And this goes into a 180 fan oven for about half an hour while we make the soup. Medium-high heat, a bit of olive oil, and we add the onions and the carrots. What you want to do is you want to cook them without color, to sweat them, to evaporate their water content and concentrate their flavors, particularly the sweetness of the onions and the carrots. So once you hear a strong sizzle, you want to lower the heat. And if you're using a cast iron pot like me, bear in mind that because of the heat retention capabilities, there's normally about a 30 second delay. So reduce the heat earlier than you think you need. We season with salt. This will also help them release their moisture. Black pepper. Once the onions are translucent and the carrots have softened, we add our garlic. The less you cook the garlic, the more garlicky they remain. And the longer you cook them, the sweeter they become. It's a matter of personal taste. If you want it really garlicky, you can add water right now. Once the garlic is fragrant, meaning you can smell the garlicky goodness, we add our carrots and butternut squash. All you need to do is that we add just enough water to cover everything. Bring this back to a boil, lid on, and you let it simmer at medium heat until the carrots and the butternut squash have softened. About 20 minutes, depending on how chunky you slice them. After about 20 minutes, we check on our roasted vegetables. Beautifully golden brown. You don't want to brown them too much, by the way. After all, carrot soup should be golden, not brown. Now, we add this to our pot. It's very tempting to top this up with water. Don't. The vegetables are all cooked already. There's no need for further dilution. So we're just going to let it simmer for an additional couple of minutes for the flavors to emulsify. And then we can liquidize the soup. All right, after a couple of minutes, everything is well emulsified. Now we make it smooth. Now you can add as much water as you desire. So for me, this is slightly too thick. Just dilute this tiny bit of water. Now we can plate. We have our beautiful carrot soup with a wonderful consistency. You don't have to keep it this thick, by the way. This is how I like it. Now, parsley would be amazing at this point, but I simply cannot accept the fact that the parsley would cost more than the carrot. So today we have our carrot soup sans parsley. But last but not least, we have our bread. which would be amazing if you want to toast it a bit and rub it with the remainder of the garlic. This is carrot soup for 6 people. I really hope you enjoy.